I should recruit somebody level Vivek. That's what we should. I think there's a hunter there that hangs out there. I'm not sure if they'll want to join us, but I mean, it could be worth a try. Maybe they might want to join the Hunter's Guild of Helgen and just hunt from pelts to dangerous creatures. Here's the idea for the guild that I have. I want the guild to be able to, you know, trade furs and everything, as well as trade rare materials. Are you serious? It's lovely out here. We got some flames over there. Somebody fighting a flame astronaut or something. There's a huge battle happening over there. Watching right now from afar and stopped. Somebody riding a horse. A bunch of deer hanging around. A nice, beautiful, I guess, a sunset. Yep, sunset happening right now in Little Vivek. And hello.
Yes.
Oh, not you.
Hello.
Hi. How's it going? Hi there. Who are you again?
I'm Albert. And this is my best friend, Meat. Say hi, Meat.
Meat is nowhere to be found. Also, his neck looks a little weird. His skin, his neck, and his face are two
Hello.
Different colors. Hi. See if we can find Meat. Where's Meat at? I don't know. It would be cool to have a dog with us. But Miku is dead now, so we can't really have Mika with us. So tragic. So tragic. God, oh man, it's been forever since I've been here. It's been a really, really long time. I remember this place. I remember questing in here and everything and learning how to apply texture mods and all that stuff. But this looks, with an EMB, this place looks a lot more prettier than it did before. Hi, how you doing, friend? Still doing good?
Something you need, traveler.
We should recruit him to the Hunter's Guild. That'd be really cool. Yeah, I'm starting a Hunter's Guild. Would you like to join? I guess he wants to join, but except he doesn't have any custom text, so... Yep, he got nothing. At least he joined. So that's cool, I guess. So, what he owns, is it ours now? No, it's not. It's still his. Well, that's... I tried. What else can we get here? Personal chest? No, I'm not gonna take that. Let's get a hunting bow. What is this? Spiky grass? Guess we're taking grass then, apparently. Excuse me, Eevee? Excuse me, but I gotta get through. Thank you. Okay, so he's gonna join us with the Hunter's Guild. Sweet. Anybody else here that we need by any chance? Let's see. Maybe them? No, not them. They're just regular people just hanging out. I want people with skill. People that have the aptitude for hunting. And we recruited the one guy from this little Vivek because he doesn't really have anywhere else to go. He has a little shack here. But with us, he was going to have a lot more opportunity to do some amazing things in the future. Which would be pretty awesome for him and for us. Because we'll be able to have more skilled hunters. As well as that hunter over there. Maybe, is there a hunter over there? I can't see. It's too far away. Here's what we need to make. We need to go to a forge, right? And we need to make ourselves a spyglass to see things better. I have the mod for a spyglass, except I don't have the materials for it. I think we need like some kind of dwarven material in order to properly make it, which I don't have. Although we should probably visit a dwarven dungeon or something. Half Moon Mill. Maybe we can do something like that. See Reinhardt and Falkreath about lumber. Well, I mean, we're already doing stuff for Helgen. We might as well continue doing stuff for Helgen as is. Already building up a guild, an entire guild anyway. So might as well help out with Helgen, take care of the whole lumber problem. See what's going on there. Might as well. I mean, it's been forever since we've done anything Helgen related. It's nice to take a breather from, you know, main quest lines and do something fun for a change. Something interesting. Maybe not combat filled, but something just fun. It's just entertaining stuff to do. I'm totally down for it. I think it's pretty amazing. And now we're here, and maybe us being here, we might find a another hunter to get him to join.
What do you need?
Not any of these guys. We can't have guards join the guild. Hello.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Okay.
Let's see here. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Items added. I wonder if he just gave us notices about the new events happening. Beware the Butcher. Kill who haunts the streets of Windhelm. I'm yet to go to Windhelm and resort the whole thing. Completely forgot about that. Oh yeah, he told us about the event. These lamp events. I think it's like honoring the dead or something. Leave a lamp out someplace or somewhere in order to signify that, hey,
They say
die, Vendor, so much as scratch it.
Okay. See, this is why we need people guarding us and killing enemies around here. If he's stuck, he probably died. But at least now we have a hooded vampire to loot for whatever they have. It don't really have much. We can only just take dust. Hello, goat. How are you doing? All right, then. So that's a thing. Bah. That's a thing. Let's go ahead and save here. You know what? Being out here in the dark is not a safe thing. It's not a safe bet. Because vampires are going to be after us the entire time. They're going to be looking for us. They're going to try to look for, you know, somebody who knows anything about the Aurel's bow. Which is why we need to establish a very awesome, you know, just collection of skilled hunters and skilled slayers out there to hunt down dangerous creatures as well as rare beasts out there. So we can set up a nice trade with whatever they have. Good to see Skyrim. In a way, you can describe us as scrappers of Skyrim that clean up the, you know, the terrible streets left and right. I remember this place. It's been forever since I've been here. This is where I started the Think Helgen Reborn questline, I'm pretty sure. And everybody's drunk. You can see it in their eyes. They just red. Their eyes are bloodshot red. And an ebony shield I completely forgot to take with me. But now we take it. We came back for it. I remembered.
Welcome to Dead Man's Drink. Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Appreciate that.
I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
Sweet. Look at this service. This is nice. And now we're back to Folkwreath Tej, or Folkwreath Aeskern, the Folkwreath Meadery. And we also got that sword. Oh, this sword, apparently.
Blade and shadow, silence and death. These are my arts. For a modest fee, I'll make great art for you.
For joining the guild, I will pay you more.
I know nothing of fear and nothing of remorse. Pay my fee, and together we will vanquish any foe.
You're a mercenary.
I am an artisan, painting in strokes of blood red upon the canvas of life. But yes, I will take coin to fight at your side. After all, where is the value in creating art if there is nobody left alive to see it?
Instead of recruiting you, how about, what are you good at? Oh, that's the, her stats. One-handed, two-handed. She's mostly a one-handed warrior. Well, I mean, she's an assassin. It makes sense. Okay, that's cool.
Blade and shadow, silence and death. These are my arts. For a modest fee, I'll make great art for you.
I'm starting a new guild. How about I pay you a salary to do hunting for my guild?
Of course.
Hey, sounds good. Great. Why don't you head over to the headquarters?
Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision.
So instead of hiring her as a mercenary, we hire her as a member of the Hunter's Guild to do the hunting for us. Because in order to be a hunter, you don't need to have a skill with a bow. And she, you know, give a reason to leave the room. You don't need to have a skill with a bow. You only need the, you only need the ability to hunt and get your target. There we go. What does it say? Nords Arise. Propaganda book. Not gonna worry about that whatsoever. It's gonna stay right here. And let's sleep for a bit. About 7 hours worth of sleep. Yeah, there you go. And then we'll take care of the lumber mill for Elgin. But this is awesome. I'm finally, my dream of forming my own Hunter's Guild is coming true. And it's really awesome, really amazing. We'll sleep for another hour.
Important deliveries to make. No time for chatting.
Okay, that's cool.
Important deliveries to make. No time for chatting.
That's fine, buddy. That's fine. Who's over here? Oh, a bunch of doors are opening and closing left and right. Let's go ahead and go over here. Oh, this guy seems to be pretty well equipped.
The graveyard has been lonely. Few pay homage to the dead.
Well, we will do so, because I think right now there's a celebration. Celebration happening right now in Skyrim where they pay homage to the dead. I don't know. It's one of the holidays out there in Skyrim.
No time for chatting.
I'm not asking for important deliveries, buddy.
Welcome to Dead Man's
Drink. Can we look at this thing? No, we can't even look at it. We can only steal the plate. I'm trying to just read the note here. That's what I'm trying to do.
I drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry.
Alright, well, let's go ahead and go out, get some apple pies, boiled eggs, green apples, and that'll be our breakfast. Okay, let's just enjoy the breakfast. See, water as usual, because it's just staple, you know, thing we can consume. Two green apples, boiled egg, and apple pie. Delicious breakfast. Not really. Well, it is delicious, just not a breakfast people are used to. What can we do with you, Cust?
These graves hold the sons and daughters of Falkreath.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Sorry for all your loss in Falkreath. Good day to you too. Let's go over to that graveyard, pay a little homage, if we can, in any way possible. Oh, never mind, more vampires attacking. Just what I wanted to deal with. Nice, got one. He got a couple more over there. Whoa, this guy is... Hello, friend. Hunting like a boss. Somebody summoned an astronaut. Are you a companion? No, you're not. Are you?
Need something?
No, you're just a mercenary. This guy's a hunter, though.
Need something?
Sir, you're really good with your bow. How about both of you join my guild?
Of course.
Nice. Go to headquarters.
Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision.
These guys are mercenaries. Oh, I see somebody sneaking around there. What is he doing? Let's check with him back. Let's get this guy recruited.
Of course.
There we go.
Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision.
Sounds good. Now, why is this guy sneaking around here? What are you doing?
Got to thinking. Maybe I'm the Dragonborn. And I just
nope. Sorry. Nothing.
My cousin's out fighting dragons.
Never mind. He's not going to tell us anything. It's like, he just looked at us. Nope, sir. Nothing. I got nothing for you, friend. Got nothing for you, indeed. Well, man. See, these attacks is something we need to be careful about. Vampires can strike at any point, and this is why we need to build ourselves a fighting force to fight against them at any moment, because they can strike at any moment. I don't know why it's always Falkreath, but Falkreath is very prone to attacks for no reason. Anyway, before we were interrupted, let's go see if we can pay homage to the graves. Is that somebody over there? No, just a cow, I think. Yeah. Let's see, graves, where they at? I think they're over here. Yeah, there they are. Wow, that's actually a lot of graves. They've lost so many people. So how can we best pay homage to the people here? I guess just pray. That's the only thing we can really do out here. Just pray for praise of there. You know, possibly in some guard. And I don't know, doing well. That's really all we can do. So let's use the remove projectile. Let's do this. There we go. Honor to the dead. I know it was the remove arrows emote, but oh no, not the emote, but action. But it looks like we're bowing down to pray to the dead and hopefully wish them great. Hopefully wishing that they are somewhere resting peacefully in Somagard or wherever they might be in the afterlife. Paying respect to the dead. That's important. I know it's video game and all, and it seems kind of silly to do something like this, but you know what? This Let's Play is partially RP-ish Let's Play, so we're gonna end up doing stuff like this every now and then. Let's go ahead and go over here to the shrine and pay homage to the Daedric deity over here. I think that's a Daedric deity. I'm pretty sure that's some kind of a deity here. I could be wrong though, could be completely wrong. Okay, nothing over here, I don't think. Oh, nice little... Oh, this is kind of nice. Nice little bonfire for people to get warm near. And, oh, that's where the lumber mill person is going to be at. Can we talk to them? It's like a block of wood right in front of it. Oh, no, that's fine. Okay, Reinhardt's house. Let's go ahead and save right here. And get it to Reinhardt's house. And see if they can help us out with our lumber problem. Because we did order lumber from Helgen, Helgen ordered from them lumber a long time ago, but we've yet to see any results, which is why we gotta, you know, see him about it. Hello. Marcus Janus sent me to check on his lumber.
Marcus Janus? Ah, yes. The fella from Corin. Well, tell him we short-handed on help right now, but we're getting to him as quickly as we can. Boland has injured his back and he's convalescing, so I don't have anyone to work the mill. I'm trying to hire more help, but I haven't had any luck. If you want your lumber any faster, you'll have to saw the logs yourself. Then I can send them to be cut into your lumber. Let's see now. Looks like his first order would be... roughly 15 timbers. So, that should get you started.
Wait, you want me to sell the logs after we already paid you?
No one has paid me anything in full. I was only paid a deposit. But I can adjust the final price to reflect your sweat equity. I will make sure you get a fair price, given the nature of my current situation. Like I said, it's only 15 logs. It won't take any time.
But we already paid you. There better be a big discount. I've heard Riverwood is looking for contracts at any moment, and I have no problem walking over there to the nice little city and get lumber from them.
Oh, no need to get hasty. I'll make it worth your while.
I really, really doubt that. Saw logs at the mill. Hi, Evie. I really don't want to do that. I feel like that's going to be just a bad mistake. Alright, well, let's go over to lumber, I guess. What the hell's going on with the guy, I swear. He has no lumber workers? He has this guy over here just cutting up his wood. What is he talking about?
Yes.
No, this guy doesn't really do much. Who are you? Roland? Do I talk to you, or what do we do here?
Nope. So Reinhard finally found someone who will work for free. Nice. I'll tell you, that man has no shame.
Work for free? What are you talking about?
Since my cousin Boland has been down on his back, I came to fill in for him, but I haven't been paid in weeks.
Why hasn't he not paid you?
I have an idea, but can't prove it. I've probably said too much already. Hey, you better get to work. Those logs aren't going to saw themselves.
Say, just because Reinhard can't pay you doesn't mean I can't. That's a good point. Good job, Tamriel. That's actually a really good point.
What did you have in mind?
I'll pay you 1,000 gold. No problem. Go ahead. 1,000 gold, you sold logs for me.
Very well. Honest gold for honest work. I'll take it.
Well, it's not that honest, bud. Alright, fill me in on Reinhard.
Well, I can tell you Boland is not down on his back. He has said that because he and I both refuse to work for free. That damn Reinhard keeps gambling away all our money.
Gambling? What kind of gambling?
It's that damn fight game. He's addicted to it. He lost all his money gambling on those damn fights. Boland tried to tell me, but I wouldn't listen. He doesn't have any money to pay me for my work, so I ain't working until he can pay me. You'll have to ask Reinhard about it if you want to know any more. But don't tell him I said anything. I'll deny it. That's all I can tell you.
Well, I already paid you, so you shouldn't have to worry about anything. Complete find out who else Roland knows about Reinhard. Confront Reinhard with information Roland gave you. Yeah, this guy got a lot to ask to answer for. We paid him deposit, or at least people at Helgen paid him deposit, and I'm here to make sure that the order went through. And if he already gambled the money away, I swear to God, I'll use these 2 dwarven weapons to cut off his head and everything else, every other part of the body. And if I can't do that, I'll get him out to do so, because I'm not dealing with this. We paid a lot of money for the logs, and we need them now, because the city needs to be developed. Okay, you. You lied to me. I know about the fight cave.
Ah, those cousins. Always running off at the mouth. Roland doesn't know what in Oblivion he's talking about.
Really? He said he was willing to work, we just can't pay him, which is why I paid him just now.
Ah, damn blabbermouth. Just can't keep his mouth shut. I'm sorry I lied to you. You had me trapped and I didn't know what to do. But say, maybe you can help me out of this problem I'm in.
Why should I help you? I can pay the guy right there and take over your business for you. We have the money. We have the weapons. We can take you out right now. Nobody will ever know you're gone. We can take over your business just like that. What is me? Oops, Serana disappeared. Hello, Serana. Magical Serana. What is making me stop from... What is going to stop me from doing that? Why should we help you?
Because, unless you do, it could be weeks before the rest of your lumber for Helgen is delivered. Roland is right. I'm broke and I can't pay anyone for the work.
What about our deposit? What happened to it?
Lost it. Gone. Went on a bad run in a fight cave. But that is where you can help me. I take my last bit of gold and bet on you. You fight and win enough times and I'll get my money back. And you keep your winnings from the pit.
What is this fight cave anyway?
It's like an arena. Men fight, people bet, try to win money. The fighters are paid if they win. If they lose, well, you know.
So, you fight to the death?
Exactly. No need to tell you the rules. There aren't any. The only exception is, the fights are between men, Mer, or Khajiit only. And of course, the occasional orc. But no creatures, giants, or the like are allowed in the pit. Only the civilized races. Beyond that, wear any armor, use any weapon or magic you like, and fight to the death.
Mer, does it mean like Argonians? Hi, Serana. You look lovely. Your eyes look beautiful. Wow! Look at her, taking over the business already just like that. Serana, we don't need this guy. Let's just take over this business. She's like, you know what, Tamriel? We're gonna take over this business. I'm just gonna go ahead and get it prepared, get it nicely cleaned up right here before we take over the business completely. Hi, your eyes look absolutely gorgeous. I got a mod for it in the description below if you want to try it out. How do I get in?
You have to have a recommendation. Take this letter to Goro. It's from a friend of mine in Cyrodiil.
Serana.
It was a fighter that met an untimely end. So don't ask any questions about it. You'll find the cave a little ways down the west road heading out of town. One last thing. We must have no further contact until all this is over. Once I get my money back, I'm done with that pit for good. You may return to see me then. But if you try to talk to me in the cave, I will act like I don't know you. I'll speak with you again later.
I swear, if you double-crossed me, you're a dead man.
Hey, calm down. You don't think I'm over? I just want to get back on my feet and I'm done with that place.
Speak with Guru at the fight cave. Serana, I love you. I really do love you. You are amazing. You're incredible. Thank you. Evie, you're still frozen. Don't know what's going on with you. Alright then, let's see what we can do with the fight cave. At least let's get over there and see, you know, the ordeal. Let's see what's happening there first, before we even do anything. I'm not sure if I want to start fighting today. I don't know. Fighting for our life, I understand, but fighting in a pit for gambling money? I'm not too keen on that. I don't know. How you doing today?
Did you need something?
Nope, I'm good, thank you. We are all peachy. You know what I should do? I should mod in some Argonian children and start training them from birth as hunters of the guild. Watch this. I think that'd be kind of cool. So where's it at? Speak with the girl. Okay, it's behind us, never mind. It's on the other side. Let's go and see if you can get over there. Hey, Serana, welcome back. Alright, let's see what's gonna happen here in the cave. Where's it at again? Is it this way? I think. Okay, it's right over here. It's right in front of us. So as long as we keep running this way, we should be able to see it at a certain point. I hope it's properly marked on the map. Hopefully. Well, we'll just have to wait and see, I guess. As much as I do want to buy ourselves a new horse, I don't know if we should. Falkreath Stables. Oh, we just lost our horse last time, and I feel so bad about it because it was the horse that I really loved. We called him Chocolate, we gave him a name, gave him awesome looking armor, and then he died to a boulder rolling down a hill. Such a tragic way to die. Didn't even die like an epic way, like picked up by a giant dragon and dropped off the mountain after having a huge fight with him or something. Like, just a very sad, tragic way. Just down, just a boulder rolled over his hoof and done. He's just out. I mean, I guess the horse was getting pretty old, but he did have him for a really, really long time, so he was going to kill over eventually at a certain point in a dangerous world that we live in, but still, it's so sad. It's very, very sad and very tragic. Shed a tear every single time for it. Alright, Serana, let's see what we can do here, if anything at all. The cage? Hold on, let me turn on the lantern. The cage or the blue room? Part of me wants to go to the blue room to see what it's like before we get to the cage. Let's go check out the blue room. I think this is where the attendants watch what happens. Let's go look at this. Never even knew the blue room ever existed. Whoop. Oh, there we go. Where does the blue room take us? The cage. Is this the blue room? Is this a place where combatants train, maybe? He looks like he doesn't want to talk to me. Lovely Mohawk, by the way. What about you guys? The hell? Hold on. Oh, it's face paint. I was thinking she's like some demon girl. Hi. Don't be insulting to me. I'm just looking at what I'm gonna have to deal with. My competition. Oh, this guy is a boss. Got some barbarian over here. I guess that's my competition. The blue room, I guess, is the, like, it's like a Korean room. What? Never mind, there's more to this. Hello. I'm guessing it's a place where the fighters train and hang out at and sleep. Yeah, it is. And we got even more of them. Okay, that face paint looks really scary, and having a blind eye does not make it any better. It's intimidating, that's for sure. Are these the pits? Yeah, I think these are the fighting pits. Okay, well, let's not go there just yet. Let's go back to the cave, not the blue room. I was thinking the cave would be the actual pit, not the blue room itself. I thought wrong. Oh. Oh, this is one. Okay, so this is the other side. So the members come from two sides and they fight each other. Oh, okay. That's kind of neat, I guess. Didn't know there was an arena-looking place here, which is, I mean, that's pretty awesome, to be honest. Let's have a little bit of water before we continue on forward. Go. Oh, I'm just going to skip the... Wait, do we need to... I'm just going to skip the drinking animation by jumping. Oh, fell down. My bad. Let's head over here. We gotta talk to... Who do we gotta talk to? This guy, this dude. Goro. I'm here to fight. Here's my recommendation letter.
Let's see. From Rolfstone, Heart of Bruma. Haven't seen him in months. Please tell him not to be a stranger when you speak to him. My, he was an impressive warrior in his day. But age eventually catches us all, I suppose. Between you and me, I heard he killed dozens of those Aldmeri bastards during the Great War. Well then, if you're a friend of his, you are certainly welcome here. Go down through the passage underneath here and see Wiglof down in the blue room. He'll get you started. And, don't get yourself killed, okay?
The guy who recommended us, it was the lumber guy, right? I doubt that he ever killed anybody. I doubt he ever hurt anybody. Wow, this place is very, very closed off from the world outside, you know? I mean, that's kind of cool and all, but still, it's like, very shady. Gambler, now we're gonna deal with him. Alright, let's go to the blue room and see what we can do. I think we gotta start fighting immediately. Well, let's come back to the blue room, I guess. Got nowhere else to go right now. Somebody will probably, like, whoop. Wrong place. Somebody, God, this place is so disorienting. Somebody will tell us where to go. We'll either start in red corner or the blue corner. One or the other. We're already getting a little hungry. That sucks. Okay, this person right here. Goro told me to see you. I'm here to fight.
You think you got what it takes to make it in the pit? We have Myrmidon matches going on right now. It just so happens I have an opening on the blue team. All pit dogs start as challengers to our Myrmidon-level fighters.
You mean with the goats?
If you want to look at it that way, be my guest. Either way, everyone starts on the blue team and proves themselves from there. Prepare yourself, and let me know when you're ready to fight.
Oh, it's like a reference about, to the Arena from Oblivion. I think that's what it is. What about my pay?
Well, you have to live first. But each Myrmidon match pays 250 gold at the cage. Report to Goru after each fight for your earnings. If you're ready to fight again, come see me.
Speak with Wiglof when you're ready for a match. I think... Serana, what do you think about this place? Do you have anything to add to this, maybe?
What now?
What are you good at? Train some of your weak. I'm starting your guild. What do you know about Alria's bow? Does it bother you working against your father? But here I need to trade something. I think we should part ways. Nope. I don't want to part ways with anybody. Not Eevee, not Serana. Anyway, I think I'm gonna just end the episode right here. We found a cave and found out that we have to, you know, fight in the fighter pits. So we'll see how that goes in the next episode. Probably open up with a bow and attack with our two weapons that we have. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the episode. We finally got the guild running. Finally have the guild going for us. And I'm very stoked. Could not be happier. Let me go ahead and switch to a better necklace that actually has protection. Health. There we go. That's what I need. RK. That's what I need, I think. Maybe I need something better? No, I'm good. Sorry. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. I certainly have. I'm looking forward to increasing our guild numbers and progressing where the guild goes in the future. Hope you enjoyed. My name is Thamriel. Like, subscribe, and as always, have a great day. See ya.